we may be on the verge of quite a breakthrough. How? Well, you can start by thanking the man who has spent 18 years letting some of the deadliest snake species on the planet bite him. He injected himself with more than 650 doses of snake venom. The video you're looking at is of Tim Friede. And as you can see, he's not exactly going Samuel L. Jackson on these guys. No, this passion project of his started when he was bitten by a snake at 5 years old. And now scientists are saying that the antibodies in Friede's blood could potentially lead to a universal antivenom that could save thousands of lives each year. Well, Tim Friede joins me now, along with the scientists researching the potentially life-saving capabilities of Tim's blood, Jacob Glanville, president and CEO of Centivax. Tim, I am just so intrigued by you and what you are doing. I mean, this is the stuff of science fiction movies. Tell me, what was your goal in actually starting to take the venom?
Well, the main goal of, first of all, thank you for having me. The main goal was to beat snakebite death. I didn't want to die or use antivenom or lose a finger or miss work. So I basically became the horse. I replaced the horse and I used myself as an experiment. So I didn't have to use antivenom.
When you would do that, I mean, I can't imagine having a snake I'm afraid of them myself and having one of them bite me, let alone microdosing in the way that you did. What was it like to have these snakes bite you, and how did it feel afterwards?
Well, it's painful because venom is very inflammatory by nature. And like when you get a bee sting, you get 1 or 2 milligrams, but in the case of like a black mamba, you can get up to 200 to 300 milligrams of venom. So it really overloads your system. So it's very inflammatory. That makes it difficult, but it's still very doable.
So walk me through, and this is a classic do not try this at home moment for people out there.
Yeah, don't
walk
do that.
Me through this process yeah. of how exactly you would dose.
Well, what I do is I dry venom out very specifically, right to the microgram. And I have a lot of notes in Excel files where I hit these particular windows to where I know I can boost up before a bite. I don't just take the bite because that can kill you. I properly boost up and methodically take notes and weigh the venoms out very specifically. It's very important to do. My goal is always to do 6 milligrams. That can achieve the highest titer level possible, IgG. And that's exactly how I did it. I've used pure venom too, but I like to dry it out for the stability reasons, so.
I can't imagine. And yet what you are doing and the imagination and the note-taking and the methodical approach, Jacob, you say that Tim's blood could potentially be life-saving now. How?
Yeah, so there's 650 different species of venomous snake around the world, and snake antivenom hasn't really changed much in the last 125 years. It's made by injecting horses with a bunch of venom, and then you take the horse's serum, and that's basically antivenom. And so I work in the area of universal vaccines. And in the process of doing this in 2017, I wondered whether, what if we could get broadly this kind of same kind of biology that creates universal vaccines, what if we could apply that to antivenom? And I started reading about these incredible stories of this guy with this astonishing immune history of all these snake bites. And I felt that if anybody had created universal immunity, the antibodies that could recognize the shared parts of the toxins of all snakes, it would be Tim Friede. And so I managed to contact him and we began a research study together.
And what's the timeline for developing something like this? I mean, to go from, obviously his blood to then being able to develop this universal antivenom.
So what we published today in Cell was that we took two of Tim's antibodies, each one knocked out an entire class of toxins shared by 300 species of snakes, half of all snakes. And that and a third compound, we showed that it was able to protect against 19 different very diverse species of these neurotoxic snakes, the World Health Organization's Category 1 and Category 2 snakes, the most medically significant snakes. That is a proof of concept of a product. Now, to go forward, there's some research we would still mm-hmm. like to do. We need to mm-hmm. manufacture it. And in about 2 years, we could initiate a phase 1 clinical study pending financial support. After that, it would be about 3 more years of clinical studies, and then it could reach commercialization.
I mean, Tim, I have to wonder, with all that you've done and the exposure, I mean, has it taken a physiological toll on your body? I know you don't do this any longer, I think, after, I think, 2018, had some pretty close calls. But what does this do to you long term? Do you know?
Well, a lot of it's psychology. You really can't have a weak nerve. You really have to go into it hardcore. I call it saddle time. And the reason I got bit so many times is to get comfortable with it. And one of the reasons I took Black Mamba and Taipan bites back to back is I became more comfortable with it. I had to live really closely to it. I just didn't want to inject once in a while or get bit once every couple of years. It became a lifestyle for me. And it's an addiction as far as I know I'm helping humanity. I know I'm helping somebody 8,000 miles away I can't talk to. And that makes me feel really, really good that everything I did was in vain, or, you know, no pun intended. I had to do it.
You don't still do this though?
Really good. No, I retired from it in December of 2018. I needed a break and just step back from it. It was a long 18 years of intensity, and I just needed to spend more time with my family and my kids and just sit back and realize that Centivax, Jake had my blood, so my job was complete. Do I miss it? Yes.
You miss it. Look, we need to talk for a lot longer to you, Tim Friede, to understand the psychology of all that you have done. But you know what? If it works, wow, what an accomplishment. Tim Friede, Jacob Blanville, thank you so much.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Scientists have worked for decades to develop a universal antivenom that cures poisonous snake bites. Now, they're on the verge of a major breakthrough thanks to this guy, Tim Friede. His blood contains crucial antibodies that react to neurotoxins from 19 different species of snakes. But that's because it's after he was bitten hundreds of times by some of the world's deadliest snakes over the course of 18 years. CNN actually sat down with Friede to learn more about his mission.
What I do is I dry venom out very specifically, right to the microgram. And I have a lot of notes in Excel files where I hit these particular windows to where I know I can boost up before a bite. I don't just take the bite because that can kill you. I properly boost up and methodically take notes and weigh the venoms out very specifically. It's very important to do. My goal is always to do 6 milligrams. That can achieve the highest titer level possible, IgG. And that's exactly how I did it. I'm helping humanity. I know I'm helping somebody 8,000 miles away I can't talk to. And that makes me feel really, really good that everything I did was in vain, or, you know, no pun intended.
Yeah, no pun intended in his veins. I'm glad there's someone doing it.
Yeah, I don't want to have snakes bite me 100 times. So I'm glad there's somebody else that volunteered for that job.
You know, what's interesting is he had a plan. He was like, I don't just do this out of nowhere willy nilly.
Yeah.